Hello, and welcome to the Create Table Statement. In this video, we will learn how to create a relational database table. At the end of this video, you will be able to distinguish between data definition language statements and data manipulation language statements, and explain how the entity name and attributes are used to create a relational database table. For the majority of people using a database, there are five simple statements to create the table. Insert data into the table, select data from the table, update data in the table, and delete data from the table. These statements fall into two different categories, data definition language statements and data manipulation language statements. Data definition language, or DDL, statements are used to define, change, or drop data. Data manipulation language, or DML, statements are used to read and modify data. We will start at the beginning and create a table. In a relational database, the data is organized in tables, like in a spreadsheet, which is columns and rows. Based on the book entity and author entity examples, we create the tables using the entity name. The entity attributes will be the columns of the table. Using the author entity as the example, assign data types to the attributes of the table. In this example, the following data types are used. Char is a character string of a fixed length. Varchar is a character string of a variable length. In addition, the author underscore ID attribute is assigned as the primary key, so that no duplicate values can exist. The primary key of a relational table uniquely identifies each tuple, or row, in a table. The author table is created using the create table statement. The create table statement is one of the data definition language statements. Data definition language statements, or DDL statements, are used to create database objects. Based on the author entity and its attributes, this slide shows the create table statement. Note that the author underscore ID is the primary key. This constraint prevents duplicate values in the table. Also note that last name and first name have the constraint not null. This ensures that these fields cannot contain a null value. An author must have a name. Now you can distinguish between data definition language statements, which are used to define, change, or drop data, and data manipulation language statements, which are used to read and modify data. You can also explain how the entity name and attributes are used to create a relational database table using the create table statement. Thanks for watching this video.